I kind of feel sad for these kids because they are not catching a break. I mean, it's hilarious at this moment. It's really hilarious at this moment. Every freaking week, there's just a new threat that is appearing for them and they're just not able to catch a break. From Nidhoggmon to whatever different Digimon, all these different strong Digimon, they're fighting just one by one. Like, there's no end to this thing. Yesterday, I saw a meme on the Digimon subreddit, which I think is just so damn apt. It's like a comparison between Pokemon and Digimon. Now, personally, I'm a huge fan of both of these series, so I really don't understand the rivalry, the quote-unquote rivalry between them. But I think here it is so apt. It basically says that a Pokemon trainer says that I wanna be the very best, they wanna catch all the Pokemon, etc. And on the other hand, we have the Digimon tamers, or rather it should be the Digidestined here, but anyway, that's not the point. And it says that I am fighting for my freaking life. I mean, that's absolutely hilarious, yet on the point, and I think that's on display in this particular episode as well. Because the group has rejoined in the digital world and things are absolutely going nuts. As Eldoradimon is treading into the new continent, the quote-unquote new continent, and there's just black lightning surrounding all of them. So hello and welcome to Undervisee, my name is Soham and today we are going to talk about Digimon Adventure 2020 Reboot Series, episode number 27. Now if you are new here then please consider subscribing to the channel since I do weekly anime and manga related content along with Digimon Adventure reviews. We're trying to hit 5000 subscribers by the end of 2020, so a like and sub would be massively appreciated. Now on to the video. So there were some really funny moments here and there throughout the entire episode and I was just laughing my ass off after watching this particular episode. Yeah, there were some very serious moments, there were some really good moments here and there, but throughout the episode there were some very funny gestures and stuff like that. Like there was this one particular moment where Eldoradimon was getting struck by lightning and everything and it was just turning around and everyone is like falling off and everything. And here there is Koshiro who is just sitting on his ass and he's watching his like tablet computer, laptop computer, whatever. And he's telling the group about the information that is at hand and he's just sliding off while Tentomon is trying to hold on to him and just making sure that he doesn't fall off the edge. This was just so hilarious. Yeah, Digimon is fun and all, but this episode especially was really amazing in my opinion. There were some very quick and hilarious banters here and there. Like that one particular moment between Greymon and Garurumon where one says to the other that don't get eaten up. That was just one quick banter, but that moment made me really chuckle up and that just reminded me of their long standing history from the original series all the way back to Last Evolution Kizuna. That was a really nice touch, really nice bit of touch, and I was super happy with it. But anyway, the plot of this particular episode was pretty straightforward. Hikari has arrived on the digital world along with other Digidestined, and of course Taichi is very perplexed by all of this and he's asking her whose voice did you hear and how did you come here, do you have a digivice, etc. Yada yada, the normal concerns of a brother. This was nice bit of stuff. But in the end, we see that lightning, black lightning stuff which is coming and Leomon basically tells everyone to escape from the top of Eldoradimon and all the other Digidestined escape along with the Digimon while Leomon and the other two Digimon try to save Eldoradimon because his wounds are still fresh from the Dark Miasma stuff and everything and he basically vanishes after this particular episode. I'm pretty sure that Leomon and gang will arrive in the future of the series at some particular moment as such, but I just hope that it's not for his death once again. This series is really taking a good turn and they are introducing some very new and good plot lines and I hope that the meme of Leomon dying again and again just stops in this particular series. It's been done to death and I just don't want to see it again. I really hope that Leomon survives this particular episode. Moreover, one more factor about this particular episode which really surprised me or rather entertained me was the fact that Digimon in this particular reboot are actually a lot more territorial and more animalistic. Like they're actually consuming and eating other Digimon in order to survive and in order to power up. This is much more than the original series portrayed and it is somewhat comparable to the Tamers level of stuff. So you understand what I'm trying to say here. Because last episode we saw the stuff with Seedramon and everyone and the same thing happens here with the other Digimon as well. But soon Taichi and the other reach on this particular continent and as soon as they land there, they are attacked by Tortomon. Now one particular bit which I really enjoyed here was the leadership role taken by Taichi because before anyone else lands there, he and Agumon just dive onto the ground and Agumon transforms into Greymon in order to battle these Tortomons. This was really nice stuff and I'm really liking his leadership role so far. but the group is soon surrounded by a huge swamp of Totomon. But then again, all of that leads us to Groundramon, an ultimate level Digimon. And I was honestly not expecting this Digimon, to be very honest. And Groundramon basically eats Totomon in order to get stronger. This was some really nice stuff, and it just goes on to show the territorial and animalistic behavior of these Digimon and how much they are feral. I'm really liking the approach that this season is taking so far. Soon they have a massive battle. In the beginning they were not able to defeat him, but after the combined effort of all the Digidestined, they are able to beat this Digimon. Again, the leadership role of Daichi is on display here, who takes the lead with Metal Greymon Ultras mode, and this was really fabulous. I think there were some frames of animation which were reused here, especially in regards to Metal Greymon's Ultras mode, but I might be wrong here as well. But either way, it was really fun and it was really awesome to see Ultras mode basically jamming the mouth of Groundramon and the others concentrating their fire at its mouth. This was some really nice bit of teamwork, and it really felt like an Avengers kind of a move. And again, it was really nice to see both Metal Greymon as well as Wargarurumon to use their alternate modes, that is the Sagittarius mode and Ultras mode. It was really awesome in my opinion. And after the Groundramon is defeated, another Digimon comes up. I mean, these guys are not getting a break. Anyway, before talking about Dark Knightmon, I think I need to address one more thing, because Koshiro tells everyone that the real world problems are just getting worse and worse because of these smaller Zudomon or stuff like that who are just eating away the data, and it is revealed to us that something very sinister is about to happen into the digital world because the real world data is getting eaten up at a very fast rate. I think all of this is really amounting or pointing us towards Zed Millennium Mon or Millennium Mon, but we'll have to wait and watch for that. I've made a video talking about it, you can watch it here for the clarifications and everything, and I hope that at the end of this series we really get to see Zed Millennium Mon or maybe even Millennium Mon. That would be really awesome. We even get to see stuff from NASA, where an experimental rocket gets blasted off because of the abnormalities into the network, and things are actually getting very serious into the real world as well. I'm just wondering at this point, I'm not 100% sure at this moment, but I'm just wondering, because this series is taking a different approach and a newer approach, will the adults and will the governments of the different worlds actually acknowledge or understand the efforts done by these kids? Because I'm pretty sure that there are very good scientists and smart people in those governments as well, and I'm pretty sure that someone will be keeping a tab on all these things occurring. So if at all there is some real world implications to all of this, then that would be really good in my opinion. But anyway, back to the digital world, Dark Knightmon appears out of nowhere and all of the other Digidestined are really exhausted, and the Digimon are also exhausted because of the previous battle. That's when Takeru steps up and Batamon evolves into Angemon. The next episode is once again going to be amazing, and in the end we get a new ending song as well. This ending was absolutely fabulous, and we finally get to see Getomon or Tailmon in this new reboot series. At least in the ending so far, we have not seen him in the actual series yet. But anyway, this episode was really awesome in my opinion. What do you guys think about all of this? Please mention your thoughts in the comment section below. So that's it for today guys, thank you so much for watching. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like it, share it with your friends and subscribe to the channel for more. This is WonderYZ, and I'll see you soon in the next video.